My name's Jeff Banks, designer. You know, what Joe and the team have done is actually try and, yeah, reflect on something, which was actually an incredible historical moment. So back in 1976, when, you know, we'd come out of a whole string of, like, very dodgy politics, to have that anarchic view on everything really swept not just music, fashion, the arts, and it actually moved everybody into a different pattern of thought. So me, I'm interested to see this movie, to see whether it actually embraces and encapsulates that, and everything that has actually gone after it. So I think a lot of kind of like modern music, modern art, actually owes its history to that moment in time. So I'm interested.
Can you define for yourself what the true spirit, the essence of punk is, and why that is so perhaps important to hold on to and protect?
That's a difficult one. It's like, you know, if I go back to, like, you know, Marlon Brando in the 50s, you know, a punk was actually this kind of, like, you know, New York street bum that was actually kind of quite aggressive, and it actually summed up a lot of the spirit of New York in the 50s. When it actually then got reinterpreted in the 70s, courtesy of Malcolm and Vivienne, a punk was somebody that was really an anarchist, somebody that was actually, you know, not necessarily aggressive. The look was aggressive, but they weren't aggressive in themselves. What they were was very vocal. They were actually speaking for a whole generation that was finding it difficult to express itself through what was the current media at the time. You know, they were like only four TV channels and sort of like 11 mainstream news titles. So to have a voice that actually started being recognised, that was quite considerable. So punk at that point took on a whole new meaning. And I like to reflect on the latter one rather than kind of like Marlon Brando's New York street punk.
Specifically in the context of fashion, can you talk about the indelible imprint that punk has left and how that continues to define our looks and our styles today?
Well, I think what you have to look at is that in World's End, seditionary sex, whatever it happened to be at that moment in time, it actually attracted every major designer in the world. They all went there because they actually realized that there was something that was happening, an undercurrent that they actually needed to be part of. So I look at kind of a lot of what Jean-Paul Gaultier did, I look at what Galliano did, you know, I look at even like mainstream designers like Gianni Versace did, you know, the safety pin dress. All of that emanated from that tiny shop in World's End. So a lot of them have got a lot of thank yous to give, and I'm just interested to see whether or not this film actually reflects all of that.